welcome to Gear House, and I'm your host Ryan Sharif, and today we'll be talking about off-road boots from O'Neill, which is the O'Neill RMX boots. So these boots I've been using for a couple of days, actually not much, because it's just been like half a month or 15 days since I started using these. So these are pretty good, they're pretty well, and I really like the build quality and the fit and finish of the boots. These are really helpful for, these are proper off-road boots. So as you can see, these are really, really well made, and O'Neill has been here for like 50, 55-ish years now, and they give off-road equipment such as the boots, helmets, and they do it. They're an American manufacturer actually, and these are actually not very much available in India. I got these from Netherlands, so these are not available here. But I haven't, if you guys also are getting it from abroad or you're looking at O'Neill products, I don't think any of, as far as I know, there's no much reviews or there's any feedback from any O'Neill RMX boots or any other O'Neill boots except the RDX, the top end boots. So these are not the top end, obviously, these are the RMX. RDX comes at the top end, and you have RSX, which is the basic beginner boots, or you have the rider boots, which is the basic off-road beginner boots. This boot comes with the metal buckles. So usually all the, you know, boots in this range from the Alpine Star Tech 3s and stuff, you get all fiber buckles and fiber straps. So these have fiber straps, no doubt, but the buckles are metal. So these are mostly aluminium, I guess, because they are light and rigid and good. But the main thing is they won't break easily. So you have a lot of colors as well. So I bought the black and gray. You can get the black and yellow, and you have black and orange, and you have a huge variety of colors as well with the O'Neill thing. But these are really comfortable. They're not true to size, because in Alpine Stars I usually have a size of 45, that is US 10 or 11 in some cases, but this one comes at a size of 46, so that is the US 12. But this do fit properly with my leg, and I have a big calf, so this also has a big calf opening. For any of you guys who have a big calf, and you even prefer wearing knee braces for off-roading, so this is also a very good boot, because they have a big opening and they have enough room for accommodating the knee brace. So this is really good. I've been riding this for not less than half a month. I'll be using this for another event probably this month end, where it'll be going to an off-road school. So let's see how it performs there as well. But these are my initial impressions of the boot, and how they feel and how they perform. These boots, any off-road boots for the matter, are very rigid at first. So it's good for you to make sure that once you get the boots, you see if it's comfortable, and once you're sure okay, this is the boots you want, these boots will not be as comfortable compared to the other, because on-road like track boots and all are really comfortable and really smooth. These boots are really rigid. So off-road boots come like that, so you have to, you know, there's a break-in period for them. So you have to wait for that to happen, and you have to make it happen by, you know, constantly. You can do that by usually putting your hand inside the boot and kind of shaking it front and back, or you can also do that by wearing these boots and climbing up the stairs and down the stairs a couple of times, you know, just basic stuff. So the boots get a little more flexible, and you get a little familiar with how the boot is. Otherwise, riding initially in the boots, changing the gear and the brake is a nightmare. You won't have any feedback, you won't have motion, it's going to be hard. But once you get after the break-in period, it's actually really good. And it's really comfortable, and you get a little more feedback, and you know what you're doing after, you know, you'll know which gear it is, and you'll get a better feel for it basically. So this is all, this is a really good boot for the price range, and it's really good. It's really, really nice, and it's overall it's really good. So the boots for themselves will cost you somewhere around 15,000 change. So they are, for that price range, is really good, because obviously this is from abroad. So in India, probably with the importing taxes and everything, you'll obviously get, if you like buy it from a shop who sells it, it'll easily be in the 25 to 30,000 range easily. So you can just expect, and it's better to get them from abroad if you're getting one of these pairs. And I'll give you a better, proper in-depth review and what my impressions later on are. This is just initial, I've just had them for a couple of days. So I'm not, I can't exactly be certain for how long do last and how what the scene. So, but the initial fit and finish, the quality, the safety is really good with this. So I'm really impressed with how they came up, and they look really, you know, good even when I wear them. So obviously they've got this carbon fiber aesthetic, and aesthetic wise it's really, really good. Only thing is, I don't know how good it'll be while you know, put them through the terrain and how tough road will be. Thank you.